Hello, dear friend. My name is Vozo. I'm sales manager from Huidu Technology. This video, we will get you how to use Android controller. We will tell you how to install it and how to use it with how to install your Android APK and how to use our API.
Firstly, we need to know what is the application of Android controller like our M21 based on Android 7.1 version system or 40S, 40M, M30 Android controller. They are all for different kinds of LCD digital signage. Some LCD screen are for touch. Some are for outdoor advertisement, like a touch screen or horizontal screen or live meetings LCD screen. And some advertisement for elevator screen, or some vertical screen, and some outdoor LCD digital signage. Both of them are equipped with an Android controller. This is the interface diagram of one of our Android controller. We call it M21. It's based on CPU of RK 3288. As you can see, this Android controller with a complete series of interface like HDMI, USB, and some LVDS and EDP. LVDS and EDP are for output for different kinds of LCD digital signage, and HDMI are for some LCD TV. We can output to LCD screen like LCD digital signage or LCD monitor through LVDS or EDP or HDMI. Both all of them works, but you need to know what is the input port of your LCD screen. Some of them are LVDS, some of them are EDP, and mostly of them are usually with HDMI. If your LCD screen is with LVDS, then you need to connect the LVDS and the LVDS backlight interface on the Android controller. But different kinds of LVDS screen with different working voltage. Some works at 3.3, and some works at 5, and some works at 12. So before we connect our LCD screen and our Android controller through the LVDS interface, we need to figure out what is the working voltage of our LCD screen and choose the right working voltage on the board. Next, EDP. Some LCD screen are with EDP input, so we need to connect our Android controller with our LCD screen through the EDP input. Also, we need to connect the backlight with our LCD screen. Also, we need to figure out what is the working voltage and can choose the right one on the board. This is the backlight interface. If you choose EDP, if your LCD screen is EDP input, also you need to connect EDP backlight at the same time. And if your LCD screen is LVDS interface, they need to also connect LVDS backlight. This port is for speaker connection. And this there is also one power connection for power supply. This video will guide you how to connect the LVDS port and the speaker. First, we connect speaker. Then we connect the LVDS backlight. Next, we connect the LVDS output to our LCD screen. Next, connect the power supply. And about the how to, because different LCD screen, usually with a different resolution, and the different LCD screen also with a different hardware configuration. So how we change the parameters of our LCD screen. Firstly, we can use the USB to change our LCD screen parameters. We can copy the LCD screen parameters files to the U disk and insert the U disk to the Android controller. We can also use our app to change our LCD screen parameters. We can download the app from the App Store, and then we can change the parameters of the LCD screen. And about how to update the program of the Android controller. Firstly, all of our Android controller is equipped with Wi-Fi, so we can use our app to connect the Android controller. And we can send the program to the Android controller through the Wi-Fi connection. And next, we can also update the program through U-Disk. We can put a video or image in the U-Disk, then put the U-Disk into the USB port of the Android controller. We can also update the program through the cloud. We can install the cloud in the LAN or on the internet. Then we can control the Android controller through the LAN or internet. If the cloud is installed on the internet, then we can manage all of your Android controller that is accessed to the internet. This is a website for logging in our cloud. You can create your cloud account through our website. The address is www.ladcloud.com. You can manage all your LCD digital signage with our Android controller through the internet. Like you can send programs through the internet. You can turn on or turn off the LCD screen or LCD digital signage. Next, we will show you the how to connect and power on the LCD screen with our Android controller. If you have any question, you can email to us or Thank you.